So put that pride to the side, then let's get paper. Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me, I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep, but I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money.
Bars, C5, just incredible. Hunger flow too, it's easy.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Cleveland Browns Stadium on the shores of Lake Erie. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Cleveland Browns. Cade York set to do the honors here, and we are underway from Cleveland. From his end zone, here's Rashid Shaheed. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara, down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second down, and it's Kamara again. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. And I don't think Kamara got there. Looks like they stopped him short. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on 4. Oh, his first throw of the game going to be intercepted. Picked off by Grant Delpit inside the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back for the score.
And I think that's a signal for how this defense wants to play. They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off. Extra point by York is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Carr to throw on 2nd down. Look at the big man rumble. How about this? Racing to the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Juwan Johnson, 81 yards. And the Saints are able to strike quickly here as they are in for 6. Will Lutz on for the point after. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. For the Browns, good starting field position as they have it first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. He'll take it past the 40 to the 41, second down.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at them, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
To throw on second is Watson. And that's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. 2 yards on the pickup there. And it brings up third and five now.
It's a game of two. Brings up third and five.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. In motion right, Peoples-Jones. Watson just beating the play clock. That's complete to Peoples-Jones. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. To throw is Watson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. So given 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it makes it third down and 2 yards to go. Watson. Hard throw, incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive. And finally, I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him. Made it very tough for him to get the ball.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt. That in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. They will indeed snap it to Watson. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. So now following the roll of the dice, they've got a first and 10 inside the 35. And Chubb will try the middle here. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. First down, Chubb. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
They go with Chubb on second down. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there, and now it's third down and inches. Cooper will come in motion right. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. It's a 10-yard pickup, and that's enough to move the chains. He finds his way into the secondary again on this drive. They might want to try and get him down a little closer to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, what do they call that? Third-level run, first level being the D-line, and linebacker second level in the secondary, the third. When you block it up well and you make the secondary do all the tackling, that will wear on a defense.
Oh, and this one, him may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, as a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss.
And Cooper will go in motion. They'll go left side on the ground with Chubb. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. And now can they reverse the trend on third and goal with the last two plays having gone backwards? And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. A field goal would break the tie, but look at this. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Deshaun Watson finding Amari Cooper. And the Browns' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And they're going to get the two-point conversion. This one's caught. And it stretches their lead up to eight. Ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. To throw, it's Carr. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now 3rd down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsome. And the Browns will take over possession here up at the 44. And when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
The Cleveland offense ready to go.
And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
After the interception, here's Watson. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
They'll bring a tight end in motion left. They go up the middle with Chubb. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one. No gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on 3rd down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the 1st down and move the chains.
Alert!
Throwing on third down, Watson. Over the middle, Amari Cooper, it's complete. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Ball at the 40 here for second and five. And again, it's Chubb. And a powerful stiff arm, it frees him. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb in the final seconds of the first half. And the Browns will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
Extra point by York is up and good. And the lead is up to 15 now. Seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The final shot here before half for Carr. The pass caught by Olave. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The Browns drive about to get started. They'll motion the tight end across the formation. The third quarter starts with a run by Chubb. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
That sure looked like a nice call by the defense, and they're very cohesive in their coverage. As soon as he cut inside, they broke on the football and met him as the ball got there and forced the incompletion.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. Back to throw, Watson. It'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
Second down, here's Chubb again. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 89 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing, because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And Chubb fighting, but nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped short of that first down marker. On fourth down, Watson into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Paulson Adebo. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Lutz to try to add the PAT. That's up and good. It's 22-14. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter. So time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little. Second down, here's Chubb again. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The offense on third down, they've hit 4 of 7. Here it's third and 2.
Cooper, the man in motion right. On third down, it's Nick Chubb. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. There we go on fourth. Watson, quick throw, and he's got Amari Cooper. And he's going to pick up the Browns' first down as the defense couldn't come up with a big play. In fact, they got six more than they needed, a gain of eight on fourth and two. Set. Alert. Cooper will come in motion right. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Second down, here's Chubb again. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play, backwards a yard.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. They run it again with Chubb. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Watson going to stay out there as they'll go for it on fourth. To throw is Watson, throwing on fourth down. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Here's first and 10. It's caught on the right side. It's Smith. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Throwing his car. This ball tipped, and it's going to be incomplete. Fortunate maybe to get that back. It's third down. This defense so strong all afternoon long. Well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. It made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And unable to connect, incomplete. I give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, they know anything less than a touchdown here at this late stage is going to be no good. They were going for it all right there, but it was just too hard to adjust to that one in the air, and it winds up incomplete.
Now Carr, gotta have this one. Quick slant here to Smith. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
They'll come up now, second and nine.
Hey, 7:34.
Carr. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked up by Ron Thornhill. And the Browns have just about sewn up this football game.
Well, this game has now been short on intrigue. That's the backbreaker right there, and it's going to put any hope of victory to bed.
Yeah, they knew they needed the touchdown, and when you have that little time remaining, they know they've got no choice except to go for broke, and that they did. But the interception, that means defeat.
The Browns drive about to get started. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all three timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. A running play here on first down is going to go nowhere as he is tackled behind the line of scrimmage.
Oftentimes when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. How about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time, ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away. So out of bounds on the punt, and the spot will be, the side judge says, right at the 35-yard line here. This is first and 10.
93.
What's up? Carr to throw. He completes it to Olave.
Close to field goal range now. Get up, get set, and spike it.
Here's second down. Here's Carr. This ball intercepted. Picked up by Ron Thornhill. And the Browns are going to hang on the final play. They get the turnover to seal this football game. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was a bit of a strange game. They were held scoreless through the entire second half, but their first half output, that's enough to carry them to victory.
And that's an odd game to watch, isn't it? Because when we saw the output in the first half, you think to yourself, okay, they've got something working here. They know what they're doing. They'll continue that along. But instead, it's goose eggs in the second half. Fortunately, enough of a cushion and enough defense to carry them home.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Browns, and they're happy in the dog pound as we say so long from Cleveland.